first bout here on WCW Saturday Night. As you see, our capacity crowd on hand will feature one of the greats in our sport.
What is that? What is that, Tone?
I think his music's not sounding.
Whoa! What's wrong with my music?
I don't know what's wrong with his music.
They're like, wow.
I guess he's having bad luck.
I knew.
Bad luck. Oh, yeah, look at him. He just said it. Well, I'll tell you what, just like listening to the number Tabernacle Choir and Hamble ain't there. It's awful.
I knew it was 7 years bad luck.
Man, Saturday night. Here he is, Mr. Wonderful.
Mr. Wonderful and Chuck Williams in our opening bout here on this 2-hour Saturday night. Don't forget, fans, we will be talking a lot in this telecast about 60 men, 3 rings for the WCW World Heavyweight title, plus the incredible matchup coming up Monday live on Nitro on TNT, Hulk Hogan against Sting. And there's Chuck Williams. He seems to be enjoying the flight of Mr. Wonderful here.
Well, I tell you what. What a role Mr. Wonderful was on when he had the hair shrink and everything, got himself all together, had his mirror, broke his window, as we've seen on television. And he's saying, just like I see, 7 years of bad luck. And Tony Schiavone, truly and surely, he needs to get himself together before World War III, because he will be one of them 60 men. I want that title.
Dream, you're right. You've got to. Who's he talking about? You've got to be at your best coming up 1 week from tomorrow night on Sunday, November 26th for the Norfolk Scope, because that's when 60 men from all across the world will vie for the most prestigious title in our sport, the World Heavyweight Championship. Into the ribcage, counting on Chuck Williams, some great champions from Lou Thesz to Harley Race to Dusty Rhodes to Ric Flair have held that belt. And now on one night, 60 men from all over the world will go after the prize.
I tell you what, you know, Mr. Wonderful now still has made him a little mistake there that he wouldn't have made, I don't think, with or without the mirror. But bottom line, he's still winning matches, but it isn't as pretty. It doesn't have that confidence. And 60 guys got to have a lot of confidence when they go in there, because it ain't no pin situation. A lot of bodies, a lot of men. You know what I mean? It's going to be a war, my friend, and that's why it's called World War III.
It's over the top rope and to the floor. Oh, he is, he's really, his mind's not in this at all.
No, he's just drunk. He's just drunk, and he's actually yelled out.
Everything is going wrong.
Let's find it. Say, where is
tell
he?
The people
look
to
at
shut
it.
Up. I mean, my name ain't Paula.
Oh, man, I tell you. He's a load up in the head, ain't he?
Oh, my goodness.
My goodness.
He is a mess. Mr. Wonderful. And it's such an inopportune time for Mr. Wonderful to have this happen to him as we head to World War III, as we've said. Nick Patrick, the referee. Chuck Williams trying to take an advantage of the mindset of Mr. Wonderful here. But underneath all of that, he is still, Mr. Wonderful, a great wrestler.
Well, let me tell you what, Tony. You know, if Williams had any real game plan at all about this situation, he would have really took it to him, because when you got a guy that said, whoa, they're going to fly through the air, look like Superman. And Mr. Wonderful just had to give him a little shoulder fake. Uh-oh, what is this?
It's a jumping pile driver.
Yes, the jumping jack pile driver.
1, 2, 3, and he can still win it, even though his mind's not in it.
Please don't play that Bethel music again.
Look, he's not even waiting for the referee to pull his hand up.
No, he's gone.
He's
drunk.
He's already out the door.
Wow. Hogan and Sting on Nitro Live, Tony Schiavone. Monday night. Wow. What a shot right here. Even at these drunk, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, with a jumping jack, pile driver, gets the 1-2-3 headed for World War III.
Mr. Wonderful is your winner. Coming up next, Mr. Wall Street, still to come, Hulk Hogan and Sting this week on Saturday.